Well, back on the road, another road trip with little mama. Back to go check out that same horse that we tried a few days ago, if you're following along. I think it's vlog number one or two.
One.
I think vlog one. Vlog number one that started it all.
To Lacombe, right?
No, you go down Highway Edmonton 2 for a bit.
And then, okay.
We're lost.
Jesus!
You better check yourself or you wreck yourself, cause I'm bad for your health. I come real stealth, dropping bombs on.
Lynn and I just got back from going to go look at this horse that we looked at in vlog number one. So we went back and tried the horse out again a second time. It was really super. That went good. I'm pretty excited about him. And anyways, I just thought today I could share some ideas, my thoughts on four things you should think about the next time you're looking at buying a new dressage horse. Let's go. What are your goals? I think this is the most important thing to think about when purchasing a new horse. And the more clear cut and defined you can be on those goals, I think the easier time you're gonna have in terms of finding your dream horse. Obviously, somebody that just wants to do some trail riding and maybe some lower level dressage is gonna be looking for a completely different horse than somebody, say, that wants to go in the FEI ring in the next 6 months. The more defined these goals can be, the easier it's gonna be to weed through the hundreds of horses that are listed for sale by asking yourself that question of, does this horse meet my goals? Define your goals, number one. Self-sufficiency. Some of you may be in full-time programs with trainers, and others of you might just ride once a year with somebody. But if you're in a full-time program with a trainer, I think it's important to have a basic level of self-sufficiency with the horse that you buy. And by self-sufficiency, I mean, can you put that horse on the aids? Take, for example, if your trainer's away for a week at a horse show. You want to be able to feel very comfortable getting on your horse without supervision and riding it around the ring. So I think an important question to ask when looking at a new horse is, do I feel comfortable enough to ride this horse without constant supervision? I think that's something very important because you never know when your trainer's not going to be there. Feel. Never underestimate your gut feeling. I think sometimes it's easy to get caught up in a horse with like super amazing training or looks really fancy or has like a big trot, and you ride it and it just doesn't quite give you that special feeling. I remember reading a quote by Edward Gall, and he mentioned he'd rather buy a horse any day of the week that gave him a good feel than one that just trotted for a 10. And I think that's really important to always consider your gut instinct when looking at a new horse. In speaking of feel, trust your trainer's opinion. You're riding with your trainer for a particular reason. They have a lot of experience. They've been there before. Use that experience to your advantage. hopefully you have a cohesive relationship with that trainer, and all these pieces will mesh together to find you that perfect horse. Here's to hoping all of you can find a horse as good as Stella. Mwah.
Falling off, gotta be compatible, takes me to my